Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel The Teacher, and today we are going to learn about this dancer animation in PowerPoint, and along with that you will also learn how to make multiple equal parts of a large picture. That is what we are going to learn in this tutorial. And this animation is inspired by the work of Szenia Zadwornik at codepen.io, and the link of this article is given in the video description. You can go and check it out. And here if I scroll down this JavaScript code, then here we can find this dancer png file. And if I select this link here and drag and drop it to the new tab, then here you can find that picture which is having 29 separate poses of the dancing girl, as you can see here. So we are going to use this png picture in PowerPoint, and along with that we will also learn that how we can make equal parts of this picture, so we can place each of this picture into a separate slide in PowerPoint. So first of all, I will save this picture by right clicking on it and choose save images, and I will save it on the desktop with the name the dancer. And now if you search Google for crop picture in segments or crop picture in equal parts, then you can find this website imgonline.com.ua. So here you can see that how you can divide your pictures into separate equal parts, and at bottom you can find this option where you can choose your file that you want to divide into equal parts. And here we have that file on the desktop, and here it is asking you that how many parts you want to make according to width and height. In the height we only need one part vertically, and in width we want to divide that picture into 29 separate equal parts, and I also want to make square those parts. And if you also want to define the difference between the two photos, then you can also make adjustment, trim adjustments here. And what output format you want, I want JPEG. You can also go for PNG as well. So if I hit the OK key, so here you can see that it has created 29 separate images by cropping each of the frame into equal parts. You can also right click and choose open link in a new tab, or you can also control click on the link to open those link into separate window, as you can see here. So instead of saving each of these pictures, you will also get a zip file which will have all those 29 separate dance poses. So after downloading this zip file, I go to the same folder and right click extract here, and here we have that folder which contains all of the 29 poses, and here we have 29 separate images that we will use in PowerPoint. So here in PowerPoint, if I open a new blank presentation and choose the layout to blank, and here if I insert the same picture, the larger one, and if I show you the property of that picture, then you can also note down the dimensions. If I right click on this picture and choose properties, then here under details you can see the width of the file, that is 7250 pixels by 280 pixels. So there is a problem in PowerPoint that if you want to divide this picture into equal parts, then there is no easy way in PowerPoint. For instance, let's say I want to make 29 separate images of this single image. So if I use the crop command in PowerPoint, then I can adjust the crop frame here, and here I have this one picture, and let's say I increase the height to 5.5 inches and align this picture to the center and the middle of the slide, and also go with the background color that is solid fill black. Now for the next pose, what I can do, I can right click on this picture and choose duplicate slide, And on the second slide, I again select the same picture and go to picture format, crop. And now I will adjust the second pose into this crop frame. And these guides will help you to identify the middle and center of the slide. Or you can also, after cropping the picture, you can again use the align center and align middle commands. So that way I have to make 29 duplicates of this slide, and on each slide I have to use this crop command again and adjust the next frame like this. So instead of doing this, after converting our single image into 29 separate equal part images, what you can do, you can open a new blank presentation and change the layout to blank and go to the insert tab, and here click on the pictures drop down button and choose this device. Now move to the location where we have downloaded that zip file which contain all the 29 separate images, and here I will select the first one, hold down the shift key and then select the last one. Hit the insert button and all the 29 images will get inserted on the first slide. And here first I will change the size, let's say 5.5 inches. Now I will go to the align drop down button, and here first I will choose align to slide. So all the pictures will get into the center and middle of the slide instead of each other. So first I will go with align to slide, then align center and align middle. And then again I will choose format background, solid fill, black to fill up the white space. So our first slide contains all the 29 pictures. If I open the selection pane from the home tab, then here you can see all the 29 pictures, each on top of the other. So on top we have picture 60 here. And now what we will do, we will right click on this slide in the thumbnail view and choose duplicate slide. And from the second slide, we will delete this picture 60. Again, I will make another duplicate. And from the third slide, I will delete this 58 picture. So that way I will start making duplicates and will delete the top picture from every slide. So that way I will create 29 total slides. Repeating the same step, duplicate the slide and then delete the top picture. That's it. That way it will save you a lot of time instead of using and adjusting the crop frame that I have shown you previously. Now here we have 29 total slides, and each slide contains a different dancing pose of the girl. So now I will again go to the first slide, will hold down the shift key and will select the last slide. And now I will move to the transitions tab, and here under the timing section, under advanced slide, I will uncheck this option on mouse click and will make a check mark on after. And here I will specify the duration that I want for each of the slides. So I will go with a very short duration of 0.10 seconds and hit the enter key. Now if we see the slideshow from the first slide, then you will see a single loop of this animation. So if you want to make it a little bit faster, then you can again select the first slide, hold down the shift key, then select the last one and reduce the duration. Let's go with 0.05. So it is totally up to you that how much speed you want to give to the animation. So if you want to make a continuous loop of this animation, then you can go to the slideshow, click setup slideshow and make a check mark on loop continuously until escape and hit the OK key and see the slideshow. Now if you go to the file menu, click export, create an animated GIF, adjust the quality and size of the GIF file and then create GIF. Let's save it on the desktop. Now if we see that GIF file, then it will also run in a continuous loop. Here that we have that file. So I hope you will like the idea and the presentation. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video. And you can also subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks a lot for watching.